Hello, everyone. I'm Megan,
and my name is Jesse.
Jesse, I really like your new hat. Is that a safari hat?
Yes, Megan, it sure is. I'm gonna wear this hat when my mom takes me to the zoo. I can't wait to see the lions, gorillas, and flamingos.
I love going to the zoo. My favorite animals to see are the tigers and penguins. When are you going to the zoo? Do you think I could go too?
Well, that's the thing. I don't know yet. My mom said we gotta wait until the rain stops, and it feels like I have been waiting forever. I'm so tired of waiting.
Waiting can be really hard, Jesse, but when you finally get what you've been waiting for, it's so exciting. In fact, there are two people in our Bible story today who had been waiting on something for a very long time.
Were they waiting to see the lions at the zoo too?
No, they were actually waiting for something even better than the lions at the zoo.
What? What could be better than the lions at the zoo?
The two people in our story, Simeon and Anna, had been waiting for the Messiah, the Savior God promised to send for many years, and finally, they were able to see him. Let's watch together to find out what happened. One day, when Jesus was still a baby, Mary and Joseph took Jesus to the temple. The temple was the place where people went to pray and worship God. Many years before, God had given special rules to all the people of Israel. One rule was when a woman's first son is born, his parents must present him to God. Another rule was that the child's parents should give an offering to God. Mary and Joseph obeyed God and brought two birds as an offering. A man named Simeon lived in Jerusalem, and he loved God. He knew that God had promised to send someone special to save people from sin. God had told Simeon that he would not die until he saw the Messiah who would rescue people from their sins. Simeon trusted God. That day, God told Simeon to go to the temple. Simeon saw Jesus there, and he picked Jesus up in his arms. Simeon was so happy. Simeon knew that Jesus was special. Simeon praised God. He prayed, "God, you kept your promise, and I have seen the one who will save people from sin." Mary and Joseph heard Simeon say those important words. Jesus was going to save people from sin. Simeon talked to Mary and Joseph. He said being Jesus's mother would be very good, but it would be very hard. Some people would love Jesus, but other people would not like him at all. Some things would happen that would make Mary very sad. Another woman, Anna, was in the temple. Anna was very old. She stayed at the temple all the time and worshiped God. Anna walked toward Simeon, Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. When Anna saw Jesus, she thanked God. People had been waiting a long time for God to send the special one who would save people from sin. Anna told other people the good news. Jesus, the Savior, is here. Mary and Joseph did everything they were supposed to do at the temple. Then they went back home. Jesus grew up and he was strong and healthy and wise. God was happy with Jesus. God had promised his people that a Savior was coming. When Simeon and Anna saw Jesus, they knew he was the Savior. Jesus came to save people from sin. We can trust Jesus to save us from our sins, and like Simeon and Anna, we get to tell others the good news. Oh,
wake up, I wanna sing and shout for every blessing and good thing that you do. I know that it's true, and so I'm gonna choose.
Mary and Joseph's baby, God's own son, was a few days old when Mary and Joseph named him Jesus, just like the angel had told them to do. When Jesus was a few weeks old, Mary and Joseph took Jesus to the temple in Jerusalem. Mary and Joseph wanted to obey God and his law. The law that God gave Moses said, "When a woman's first son is born, his parents must dedicate him to the Lord." The law also said that the child's parents should give a sacrifice. At the temple, Mary and Joseph presented Jesus to the Lord and offered two birds as a sacrifice. Another man was at the temple. His name was Simeon. Simeon loved God, and he trusted in God's promise to send a Messiah to save people from sin. God's Spirit was with Simeon, and God had told Simeon that he would not die until he saw the one who would rescue people from their sin. That day, God's Spirit had led Simeon to the temple. Simeon saw Jesus and picked him up in his arms. God's Spirit showed Simeon that Jesus was the promised Messiah. Simeon was so happy. He praised God and said, "Lord, you can let me die now. You kept your promise, and I have seen the one who will save people from sin." Simeon said that Jesus would save God's people, the Israelites, and Jesus would also save people from other nations. Mary and Joseph were amazed at what Simeon said. Simeon blessed Mary and Joseph. He told Mary that being Jesus' mother would be a very good thing, but it would also be very hard. Some people would love Jesus, but others would hate him. Things were going to happen that would make Mary very sad. A woman named Anna was at the temple too. Anna's husband had died, and Anna was very old. She stayed at the temple and worshiped and served God all the time. Anna came up to Simeon, Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, and she began to thank God. Anna talked about Jesus to people who were waiting for God to keep his promise to send a Savior. She told them the good news, the Savior was here. Mary and Joseph finished dedicating Jesus and making sacrifices to God. They obeyed God's law. Then they went back home to Nazareth. Jesus grew up and was strong and healthy. He was wise and God was happy with him. Throughout the Old Testament, God promised the arrival of a king who would redeem people. When Jesus arrived, Simeon and Anna knew he was the promised Messiah, God's own son. We can trust Jesus for our salvation, and like Simeon and Anna, we should share the good news.
I get the question of why move back to Puerto Rico. In the last 10 years, Puerto Rico has experienced financial crisis, political crisis, crises with hurricanes and earthquakes. And on top of all of that, you've got the COVID-19 pandemic. And so they're like, why would you go the opposite way? Everyone's trying to leave. I think there's a lot of opportunity here in Puerto Rico in terms of ministry. A lot of the folks that we minister to just live alone because families have moved onto the mainland and people tend to leave behind some of their most vulnerable family members. It takes their support system away from them. And so one, who I later met as Rosa, sent me a text that said, "I live alone, I don't have any food left, please just help me." So I asked, "Can I call you?" And realized that she lived near one of our local pastors. And so he and his wife came here and went to see Rosa and really ministered to her and invited her to church. She agreed and listened intently to the message and then after the service accepted Christ. This is something that God is doing and I get to join him in because of what Christ has done on our behalf, and in gratitude, we respond by serving others. And so that's the importance of giving, because that enables us to continue to meet these needs and ensure that the gospel is proclaimed and preached and that churches are planted and that missionaries are sent. Puerto Ricans, they've been through a lot, and yet we're gonna do what we need to do to overcome this, and we're gonna overcome this together.
Thank you. in him. That's why my hope is in. My hope is in the Lord. My hope is in the Lord. I belong to him. He will never let me go. Oh, oh, oh. My hope is in the Lord. I can count on him. My hope is in the Lord. I can't help but feel a little down.
Hey friends, did you like that video? Yeah, you did. Why don't you check out some more right here?